Hello everyone, today once again I am there with you and yesterday we have talked about the test cross in which we have tried to identify the genotype of a given organism. Okay, and now we are going to proceed with the back cross. As the name itself indicates that we are going to do something which will be taken from the back. Okay, so that cross is known as back cross, and why we are doing this, that it is basically the sort of rapid method of purifying the desired stock, and this stock may be of the animals or it may be of the plant. Okay, now what it is? It is a genetic cross between the hybrid organism. This hybrid organism, I'll tell you, is the organism which you get in the F1 generation. Okay, that is the same progeny. Okay, and one of the original parental type. और उस क्रॉस में क्या करना है आपको, इस हाइब्रिड ऑर्गेनिज्म का क्रॉस कराना है उसके किसी एक पेरेंट के साथ, एंड दैट पेरेंट मे बी रिसेसिव पेरेंट और इट मे बी द डोमिनेटिंग पेरेंट. ओके, व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू डू दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ क्रॉस, द क्रॉस इन बिटवीन द प्रोजेनी एंड द पेरेंट, this cross is known as back cross. ठीक है, and one more thing which is very important for you, whatever the test cross you have done, in that test cross you have crossed the F1 progeny with the recessive parent, that also comes under the back cross. So all the test cross you can consider as a back cross, but all the back cross are not test cross. Why? Because the test cross, we are going to cross the progeny, that is the F1 hybrid, with only recessive parent. And here in back cross, we can cross with any of the parent. That parent may be recessive parent or it may be dominant parent. Okay, let's start. So here we are going to take the example of pea plant. And here we have considered the collector of hive. Okay, so phenotype, what we have taken, see, in this I have already told you that I am going to do the cross with either of the parent, it may be dominating, it may be recessive. So here phenotype I have taken tall. Okay, and it is going to cross with the progeny. So progeny which we got in the monohybrid cross was also tall but heterozygous. It was heterozygous tall. Okay, so here you will be able to understand how this cross is going to happen. See here, this is the dominating parent, so the genotype will be both capital T. And because this is the progeny, this is the progeny or F1 generation. So here it is having the genotype, that is uppercase T, and one will be the lowercase T. Okay, then when you are going to make a Punnett square for this one, you can consider it as a father and this one as a mother. So here we are going to take the example. Let's do this. And this one will be here. So when you will be making the cross in between both, then you will get tall. Here, this one is going to do with this one, tall. And here, tall but hetero. This one, homo. Here also, homo. And this one, the fourth one will be, again, it is going to be the tall but heterozygous. So, this is what you are going to have when you are going to cross in between the dominating parent as well as the F1 generation. Okay, the another thing which we can do is the cross in between phenotype. Here we have taken dwarf. Here we have taken the dwarf parent along with the F1 hybrid, that is tall but heterozygous. So here, because it is a dwarf, so genotype will be both lowercase t. Okay, and here this is F1 hybrid, so it was heterozygous tall. So here we are having the genotype, this one, uppercase T along with one lowercase t. So here we are going to make a Punnett square. Before that, we have to make gametes also, that it will be having. Okay. So here we are going to make a plot of Punnett square over here. So here, two lowercase t along with this one. Okay, so here what you are going to get, uppercase T along with lowercase t, here also uppercase T, lowercase t, and in this both lowercase t, and here both lowercase t. So here you are able to see that here the ratio which you got in a tall and a dwarf, that is a heterozygous tall. Here also heterozygous, here this one is dwarf but homozygous. This ratio you got in a test cross also, that is 2:2, when you will be doing then this will be 1:1 on the whole. Okay, so this sort of ratio is always there in case of test cross only, but when you are talking about the back cross, then this ratio may be 1:1, and other also, here you are able to see this both are homozygous tall. So here also this tall 2, and here this one is also 2. Okay, so this sort of ratio also you can get. Okay, so the one thing which you have to remember, in case of back cross, this ratio may be 1:1, and it may be other value also. It is not always 1:1. Okay, so this is what is a back cross. The thing which you are supposed to focus on is that back cross means the crossing between the F1 progeny along with its dominant parent, or it may be with its recessive parent. But when we are talking about the test cross, then it is always with the recessive parent only. So it was all about your back cross and test cross. Okay, I do this much. Thank you.